Hello friends, welcome to the NCERT sessions. In this video, I am going to explain chapter 7 of class 7 NCERT of geography. So let's get started. Here we have definition of a site. Site is a place where a building or a settlement develops. This is called site. Generally, the natural conditions for the selection of a site are favorable climate, availability of water, suitable land, fertile soil. ఇక్కడ ఏం లేదు సైట్ అంటే ఎనీథింగ్ ఎనీవేర్ ఎనీ ప్లేస్ వేర్ వి వాంట్ టు లీవ్ సో మనం ఉండే ప్లేస్కి మనం చూసుకునే కండిషన్స్ అన్నమాట సో సెటిల్మెంట్స్ సెటిల్మెంట్స్ ఆర్ ప్లేసెస్ వేర్ పీపుల్ బిల్డ్ దేర్ హోమ్స్ సెటిల్మెంట్స్ ఆర్ టూ టైప్స్ పర్మనెంట్ అండ్ టెంపరీ సెటిల్మెంట్స్ విచ్ ఆర్ ఆక్యుపైడ్ ఫర్ ఎ షార్ట్ టైమ్ ఆర్ కాల్డ్ టెంపరీ సెటిల్మెంట్స్ జనరల్ ద పీపుల్ లివింగ్ ఇన్ డీప్ ఫారెస్ట్ హాట్ అండ్ కోల్డ్ డెజర్ట్ మౌంటైన్స్ often dwell into temporary settlements. They practice hunting, gathering, shifting cultivation and transhumance. But in these days, more and more settlements are permanent settlements. In these permanent settlements, people build their homes to live in, like this. So what is transhumance? It is a seasonal movement of the people. People who rear animals move in search of new pastures according to the changes in the seasons. So the villages are the rural settlements where people are engaged in activities like agriculture, fishing, forestry, craft work and trading etc. Rural settlements can be compact or scattered. A compact settlement is a closely built area of dwellings wherever the flat land is available. In the scattered settlement, dwellings are spaced over an extensive area. This type of settlement is mostly found in hilly tracts, thick forests and regions of extreme climate. So what is a compact settlement? Chala daggar daggaraga oka area build ayi unna danni manam compact settlement ani antam. Whereas scattered settlement ante entante chala duram duranga oka spaced area lo extensive area lo హౌసెస్ బిల్డ్ చేసుకొని ఉండడాన్ని స్కాటర్డ్ సెటిల్మెంట్ అంటాం హే యూ క్యాన్ సీ ద ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఆఫ్ కాంపాక్ట్ సెటిల్మెంట్ సో హౌసెస్ అనేవి చాలా దగ్గర దగ్గరగా ఉంటాయి వేరాజ్ ఇన్ ఏ స్కాటర్డ్ సెటిల్మెంట్ హౌసెస్ ఇలా చాలా దూర దూరంగా స్పేస్డ్ ఏరియాస్లో ఉంటాయి నెక్స్ట్ వీ హ్యావ్ ట్రాన్స్పోర్ట్ వాట్ ఈస్ ద మీనింగ్ ఆఫ్ ట్రాన్స్పోర్ట్ ట్రాన్స్పోర్ట్ ఈజ్ అ మీన్స్ బై విచ్ పీపుల్ అండ్ గూడ్స్ మూవ్ ఇన్ ఓల్డెన్ డేస్ ఈవెన్ Now in some places, animals are used for transportation like donkeys, mules, bullock carts and camels are common in India. In the Andes mountains of South America, lambs are used as are yaks in Tibet. So there are four major means of transport. They are roadways, railways, waterways and airways. Important fact here, there are several national and state highways in India. The latest development in India is the construction of expressways. The golden quadrilateral connects Delhi, Mumbai, Chennai and Kolkata. Coming to roadways. The most commonly used means of transport, especially for shorter distance, are roads. They can be metalled and unmetalled. That is, we have pakka roads and kacha roads. The plains have a dense network of roads. Roads have also been built in terrains like deserts, forests and even high mountains. Manali Leh Highway in the Himalayan mountains is one of the highest roadways in the world. Roads built underground are called subways or underpaths. Flyovers are also built over raised structures. These all we know. So manak telusinave manaki kacha roads and pakka roads untai. Deserts low, forests low, pedda pedda mountains paina kuda manam roads anevi construct chesam. Himalayan mountains paina unna Manali Leh Highway is the highest roadway in the world. సో అండర్గ్రౌండ్లో బిల్డ్ చేసే రోడ్స్ని సబ్వేస్ ఆర్ అండర్ పాత్స్ అంటాం కొంచెం రేస్ చేసి కట్టే వాటిని ఫ్లైఓవర్స్ అంటాం నెక్స్ట్ వీ హ్యావ్ రైల్వేస్ సో రైల్వేస్ క్యారీ హెవీ గూడ్స్ అండ్ పీపుల్ ఓవర్ లాంగ్ డిస్టెన్స్ అండ్ క్విక్లీ అండ్ చీప్లీ ద ఇన్వెన్షన్ ఆఫ్ స్టీమ్ ఇంజన్ అండ్ ఇండస్ట్రియల్ రెవల్యూషన్ హెల్ప్ ఇన్ స్పీడీ డెవలప్మెంట్ ఆఫ్ ద ట్రాన్స్పోర్టేషన్ ఇన్ సమ్ ప్లేసెస్ వీ హ్యావ్ సూపర్ ఫాస్ట్ ట్రైన్స్ We have well-developed advanced technological skills enabled railway lines. Indian railway network is the largest in Asia. Here we have the train from Xining to Hassa runs at an altitude of 4000 meters above the sea level and the highest point is 5072 meters. Here we have the Trans-Siberian Railway is the longest railway system connecting St. Petersburg in Western Russia to Vladivostok on the Pacific coast. Next we have waterways. So there are two types of waterways, inland waterways and sea routes. Navigable rivers and lakes are used as inland waterways. Some of the important inland waterways are Ganga Brahmaputra river system, the Great Lakes in North America and the River Nile in Africa. Sea routes and ocean routes are mostly used for transporting merchant and goods from one country to the other. These are connected with the ports. Some of the important ports of the world are Singapore and Mumbai in Asia, New York, Los Angeles in North America, Rio de Janeiro in South America, Durban and Cape Town in Africa, Sydney in Australia, London and Rotterdam in Europe. Next we have airways. This is the fastest way of transport developed in early 20th century. It is most expensive also. So some of the important airports are Delhi, Mumbai, New York, London, Paris, Frankfurt and Cairo. Next we have communication. Communication is a process of conveying messages from one place to another or from one to others. Through newspapers, radio, television, we can communicate with a large number of people. Therefore, these are called as mass media. Also, we have satellites. These satellites made the communication even faster. Satellites have helped in the oil exploration, survey of forest, underground water, mineral wealth, etc. And also for sending electronic mails or emails through internet, wireless telephonic communications through cellular phones, etc. By this we completed this chapter. Guys, I am explaining each and every point because now it may seem to be unimportant, but when you start to write some descriptive answers, you will search for words and sentences and matter for your answer. At that time, you will be searching for Google and all for the information. It is all waste of time. Just go through the NCERT books word by word at least once, so that when you are stuck with the words, you can always refer to this NCERT. And the speciality of the NCERT books is they are very simple in language and very easy to understand and very very useful to write in your answers. Okay guys, by this we completed chapter 7 of class 7 NCERT geography. Thank you.